You've done simple maths at school, haven't you? Sets and subsets. Well, it would seem from what I understand that a number of people in the Scottish National Party haven't. Let me explain Scottish independence by way of using simple maths such as Venn diagrams. Right? Dead simple. But obviously not for an SNP guy. Okay, so diagram at the top. That's what exists today. UK political union. And the overlap is just really to show that political union and also the overlap between laws. Although Scottish law is different from English law, there is overlap in terms of commonality, common law, civil law, etc. Okay? Now, and there's certain parts of the law in England and Scotland which are exactly the same and have to be due to the political union. Then below the line, you have what Mr. Salmond and his party are selling to the Scottish people as independence. That is, Scotland splits and becomes an entirely sovereign nation. No longer joined at the hip with the rest of the United Kingdom. Sounds great, doesn't it? But just wait a minute. You see, there's something just a little more to this Venn diagram that Salmond and his SNP party is really not bringing to your attention. And that is this little red circle that contains the subsets of Wales, England, Northern Ireland, Scotland. And it would still contain Scotland, even though we broke away from the political union with the rest of the United Kingdom. And this, as I say, is what Mr. Salmond and his party really don't wish the Scottish people to understand or grasp. But the idea behind this little video is to make it quite clear what it is that Salmond isn't telling you. You see, this little red circle that surrounds us all is called the Crown Estate. And it's the Crown Estate who administer and basically control the land, the minerals, and the oil around the shores of the United Kingdom, including the UK continental shelf. And if Mr. Salmond wished to seriously make Scotland sovereign, okay, and independent, then the Crown Estate would be very, very, very upset with Mr. Salmond. Let me explain a little further. Now please bear with me here, because I'm really trying to do you a favour. I seriously am. Doing myself a favour as well. So let's just read this together and fully understand what it means. I sent the SNP a complaint, and I also sent it to the SNP HQ, a video and attachments, to explain why I believed and that I know that they are deceiving the Scottish people. Now, without going into the detail of that, it's elsewhere on videos, etc. The SNP response from a little guy called Kirk Torrance, who thinks he knows a thing or two, comes back and he says, "The Crown Estate is indeed property and area belonging to the Crown." So, one admission. Of course it is. However, it is not the private property of the monarch and is administered by Crown Estate Commissioners, who are accountable to the Westminster Parliament. All well and good. I don't disagree with them. Not one jot. He goes on. If control of the Crown Estate was devolved to Scotland, then it would be Scottish Parliament that would be accountable for its management with any excess revenue from the estate. Excess revenue? From the estate going to the Scottish Government. As reported yesterday, the Crown Estate has achieved record profits this year. With access to these funds, now this is it, with access to these funds, the Scottish Government would be able to provide better support to our economy and help create jobs and support employment. The SNP has been and continues to campaign for control of Scotland's share of the Crown Estate. Now, to respond to that SNP response, it's this simple. SNP are stating it is necessary to control their share, that is Scotland's share. So all the oil and minerals and land wealth, infrastructure, whatever, okay, their share that is in Scotland, then Alex thinks it's right that we should control that. Now, he's absolutely correct, Alex is. Yes, Alex, you are right. But, if the Scottish Government was to make Scotland entirely independent of the UK and of the Crown Estate, then the Crown Estate would only be left with England, Wales, and Northern Ireland to profit from their resources. Do you see the point? Scotland would be independent, it would be separate. Therefore, the Crown would not get its grubby little mitts on the income from Scotland, because the Crown Estate would not have Scotland. Do you understand that? So, but if we are independent, then we would not be part of the UK, correct? Well, yes, that's what SNP are selling you. And from a political union perspective, that's true. But there's something behind political union. And if we're not part of the UK, then what has the Crown Estate got to do with Scotland? Absolutely nothing. If we were truly independent, and if it wasn't just a separation politically, at government level. Let me explain by the following diagram. I hope you'll understand this. Okay, compare this diagram with the previous diagram. The previous diagram showed that Scotland was within the red set as a subset along with Wales, England, and Northern Ireland. And that red circle, that red set, represents the Crown. And I've also shown here a blue circle to represent the EU. Because EU law and EU legislation is taking precedence over UK law, as you all know. And it would with Scotland as well. However, that's just to show that. Ignore the blue circle for now. The red circle still remains because the Crown Estate has control and ownership of the entire land of the United Kingdom. Okay, whether it exists as separate countries or not, the Crown Estate still has control and ownership of the land, of the seabed, of the minerals, of the oil. So Scotland, even with Salmond's independence, would remain within that red circle. And therefore, our oil revenues and resources, etc., profits from it, would still be paid to the Crown Estate. Now, I say definitely that the Queen, I mean, she is profiting £38 million from the seabed regarding the wind farms, right? And she's profiting personally from that, even though young Kirk from SNP doesn't agree with it. It's in black and white. But whether or not it is the Queen who owns, ultimately, the Crown Estate, and I can assure you it is, maybe along with others, but whether or not it's her, the point is, the Crown Estate still lays claim to all Scottish minerals, land, and oil that they so choose to control. And Salmond and party are saying, yeah, let's destroy the political union, but we'll retain the monarchy as head of state, and we will remain within this red circle of the Crown Estate. Now, that is not sovereignty. It is not independence. The only way of Scotland getting true sovereignty and independence is to remove us from that red and blue circle out as an independent nation. But that is never going to happen under the SNP. And that is what Salmond and SNP do not wish you to know. Because they will profit individually and as a political group. They will profit from the Crown Estate, and they will profit from membership of the EU. And the Crown will still profit from Scottish resources, and it will not go to the people. I can assure you of that. So please, Scotland, wake up. And with that, I'll leave you to read the following, and I suggest you have a real damn good think about this.